that we see, not the walls or the place, they're not why we celebrate. Come on now and praise the one you seek. All bow down with hearts surrendering. It's not the world that satisfies the thirsty hunger deep inside. Not for wealth, not for fame, that we're gathering his name. Come on now and praise the one you seek. All bow down with hearts surrendering. Open heaven's gates, voices raised. Dance to freedom, one who loose the chains.
Hello, 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 hello. That's the bad man. Hello, hello. Hello, India. Hello, hello.
Amen. Amen. They just asked me to scream over here. Amen. Amen. God bless everyone. We're enjoying the little breath, the little rain. Thank God, the clouds, you know. Too much sun is not good. Too much of everything is not good. Too much hot dog is not good. Amen. Who speaks Spanish over here? Who understands Espanol? ¿Quién entiende Espanol aquí? Amen, amen, amen. Praise Jesus. The one born in Bethlehem, the one who was crucified in Jerusalem, and the one who will come down on earth, to pick us up, to pick those who are waiting for him. Who is waiting for Jesus? Who is waiting for Jesus? ¿Quién está esperando a Jesús? Huh? Not Jesus the neighbor, but Jesus the Almighty God. Amen. Que una vez más, ¿quién entiende español aquí? Para predicar en español, si no predico en inglés. ¿Inglés o en español? ¿Inglés? Ah, you want to preach in English or Spanish? English. Amen. We'll do it in English then.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And no matter what language, you're going to get Jesus.
Amen. You know, God is the...
Spanish,
amen. Spanish, tipo Chicano, tipo LA, you know, I was born in East LA, right? I was born again. I was born again, that's the way. Hey, we got the mic?
We got a mic. I can hear you very well.
All right. I keep hearing myself go and come, go and go, you know.
Probably the mic. They need new batteries. Get another mic.
All right. Give me the pink one, then. Hello, hello. Hey, here we go. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Is anybody out there? Anybody wants to praise Jesus?
Amen.
Anybody adores Jesus?
Amen.
Anybody worships Jesus?
Amen.
You know what? Let's do something different today. Amen? Who wants to do something different today? Who wants to do something new today? Something different. Amen? What, two hands? Three hands? Another hand? Okay, who's listening to me?
Me.
All right, amen. Okay, let's do something different. I'm serious. I'm serious. Listen up. Please. God is watching over us. He loves us that he gives us great weather, great food, because in other countries, people are starving to death. Okay? And you know, the many countries where people are suffering. So let's do something totally different today. Amen? Let's humble ourselves Let's humble ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Over here in Pioneer Park, let's humble ourselves by bending our knees, kneeling, okay? In the Old Testament, David even put himself face in the ground, the dirt, you know, face to face. Let's humble ourselves and let's kneel before the Lord and thank Him. Thank Him for everything He has done for us, the good and the bad, the things that we have and the things that we do not have. Amen? Because in other countries, people, there is kids, men and women, suffering of hunger, dying of hunger. And we have a lot of food over here, clothes, toys, you know? But in other countries, they don't even have that. So let's humble ourselves. Let's kneel before our God, our Creator of heaven and earth. Let's kneel before Him and thank Him for everything that He has given us. Amen? Let's do that. Together us, one body, because we are members of one body. And Jesus is the head. Amen? And we kneel before You, Lord, thanking You, Jesus, for everything You have done in our life, for the things we have, for the things we don't have. Thanking You, Father, for the wisdom You have given us, for the food You have given us, Lord. I thank You, Jesus, because we are able to eat at least one meal a day. A lot of us eat three meals a day, but there's people in other countries where they don't even have that. Like Haiti, like Africa, like Nicaragua, some parts in Honduras, they don't even have that. And we thank You, Lord, for the food that we have today, Lord. Because when Your disciples ask You, teach us to pray, You said in Your prayer, give us this day our daily bread, which is our food. Father, this body needs food all the time, Lord. And we thank You, Jesus, that we have hot dogs, beans, ice cream. Some people in other countries don't even know what ice cream looks like. But I thank You, Lord, that we have all this over here. In Jesus' holy name, we worship You, Lord. We thank You, Lord. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. And you know, with that, brothers and sisters, I'm telling you the truth. There's other countries, other people don't even know what ice cream looks like. You know, and ice cream is delicious. You know, if you like sugar like me, it's delicious. But there's other countries that people don't even know what ice cream looks like, you know? And we have tons of them over here. So let's thank God for everything that we have. Amen. And with this also, I like for us to sing the song Amazing Grace. You know, I don't have any music, but we'll sing it a cappella, you know, with our voice, with our souls. Amazing Grace. Amen. You want to lead us? No? All right. Amen. Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now blind, but now I see. Oh, many dangers, toils, and snares I have already gone. This grace has brought Praise God. 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 The last trumpet is sounding, people. You know, a lot of people are saying we're in the last days, but I tell you, we're in the last few seconds. If a day for God is like 1,000 years, imagine what a second could be like. You know, we see all these signs happening all over the world. We see how the U.S. has fallen apart all because they want to take Jesus out of it, man. But God maintains this country because there's still a few chosen ones, a few good ones, just like that commercial, the few good soldiers who are willing to battle, to fight the enemy, Lucifer, and all his demons. And like the song says, onward Christian soldier, you who fight the good battle, you, the Christian that is willing to die for Jesus. You who is not afraid to say, yes, I am a Christian. Yes, I'm born again. Yes, if you want to throw me in jail, throw me in jail. Because let me tell you, they will throw you in jail. And they have. I mean, I've been in jail also, you know, because of preaching the word. I have to go out and taking people out of jail, you know, brothers that are preaching the word of God. But other sinful people that are doing things in public eyes, they leave them alone. They don't touch them. There's other countries in the world that have the liberty that you can go out in the street and preach. This country has closed their doors many, many times to those who are willing to spread the gospel. I just saw a sign on my way over here that says, God bless America, celebrate the 4th of July. I mean, that's a sign that I finally see after so many years. You know, this state doesn't celebrate the 4th of July only because it falls on Sunday. You know, because of the religion traditions. Just because it falls on Sundays, they don't celebrate it. But you know, celebrating a country's birth is like celebrating your own birthday. It's really important. You know, but the most important thing is celebrating when you came to Jesus Christ. That's the best birthday or birth celebration that you could ever have. You know, Jesus says that if you deny yourself, if you deny yourself and you follow me, you take up your cross and follow me, I will give you the authority, I will give you the wisdom, I will give you power to kill the serpents, to cut the head off the giant, to tear down the walls of the enemy. And you will conquer, and you will enter into this land, and you will conquer it. Only if you believe that Jesus Christ is the King and Savior, the only mediator between God and men. The only mediator between God and men. No one else. No Buddha, no Mary, no Joseph, no nothing. Only Jesus Christ, the only mediator between God and men. Forget about the cow, forget about the moon. You know, like in ancient Maya, they worship the moon. Like in Asia right now, they're worshiping the cow. Let's worship the one true and only living God, Jesus Christ. The one who died on the cross in Jerusalem because his own people rejected him. El Señor Jesús. The only one who will come on the clouds with his only angels, his army, his holy army. Forget about the National Guard. Forget about the Navy. The holy army of God,
coming on the clouds for you, for me, for those who are waiting for him, for his bride that is waiting with white, clean clothes, separated from the world. And that's how we need to be, separated from the world. The traditions, the beliefs that this world has. Long time ago, I disconnected Comcast cable TV because all I see is garbage on that TV. You know, and I got three kids. You figure three kids are missing, you know, cable TV. No, they don't. You figure three kids, you know, they watch Disney Channel or cartoons. They don't even miss that. You can ask them. Take them one by one privately and ask them, do you really, is it true? You know, you can ask them. They don't care about the things of this world, the traditions of this world, because the only thing we care about is having that holy communion with the Lord Almighty, the one who opened up the Red Sea, the one who brought down the walls of Jericho, the one who fed thousands of people, the one who brought flood from to destroy the whole earth, and the one who will bring fire on this earth because of the many sin that this earth and the human beings are doing every day. Why do you think God is bringing fire upon this earth? The Bible says that the elements of this earth will melt with fervent heat. Why do you think God will bring fire upon this earth? Is it because we've been good people? Is it because we've been good children? Is it because we do a lot of good things? Do you think God will bring and melt the elements of this earth because we're good boys? No. There's so much sin in this world. That's why you and I, who is listening to his word, need to listen and obey what God says. Love your neighbor. Love those who persecute you. Do good to those who do evil on you. If anybody is in need, help them out. You know, there was a homeless who now has a lot of money, and we heard of him in the news. That's great, that's awesome. It could happen to you. It could happen to 20 of us, you know. Life can change just like that. But you need to keep praising Jesus all the time. And you'll see miracles happen in your life. Miracles. You know, the cops surround us all the time. They put cameras everywhere because they want to watch us every move. Well, you know what? God already does that. God already watches us every move. Just because there's a camera over here, we need to be careful. Because the government or the state is watching us? Well, you know what? God has been watching us since day one that this earth was created. And if we get so scared and we're careful how we behave because there's cameras, how about when God watches us all the time? We need to be careful how we behave because he is watching us. Right now, he's watching us. He's hearing every word we say. Even when we talk bad, even when we talk good, he's listening to every word we say. He's watching us in our darkest moments. Even when you're by yourself and nobody is looking at you, he's watching. When you're in your room, sitting there all by yourself, crying, he's listening to you. When you think everybody has left you, and you're in despair, and you're suffering, and you're in pain, he's listening to you. He's watching you. He did it for me for 4 years when I was in prison back in the 90s. He watched over me. And there's not one scar on this body because of that prison life. But you need to trust and obey. Like the song says, trust and obey. Because that's how we become members of His family. That's when we become members of His family, born again. Like the Bible says, like Jesus told Nicodemus, you must be born again in order to enter into paradise, in order for your name to be written in the book of life.
Good to see you guys.
I mean, you know, most of us have a, or all of us have a social security number. Our number and our name is written in the book of the city, of the state, of the government. That's fine, you know. And we have seen in history that every nation that rises falls. The Assyrians, the Romans, the Babylonians, the Americans, they will all rise and they will all fall. Look at Hitler. Look at Mussolini. Look at all those guys that fell. Yes, our names is written in the book of the state government, you know, because of our social security or whatever, pension, you know, retirement is written. Our name is there. But you know what? Most importantly is having our name written in the book of the Lamb, the book of life. And I ask you today, are you sure that your name is written in the book of life? Do you know that your name is written in the book of life? And if you're not sure, all you have to do is, like that thief, that criminal on the cross, looked up to Jesus and said, remember me, Lord, when you come as a king, when you go into paradise, remember me. Even though I have broken all your laws, that criminal on the cross, that criminal on the cross, he was being punished for some crimes he did. Those two criminals right next to Jesus, they were not being crucified for being good boys. And one of them said, remember me. So it doesn't matter how many laws you have broken, how many people you have hurt it, how many times you have spit it on somebody's face. It doesn't matter how many times you have talked bad about God. He can say to you, like he said to that thief on the cross, today you will be with me in paradise. Today. Not tomorrow, like the government says, oh yeah, we'll send you your social security check next week. Today, you'll be in paradise with me. Today, you can have your name written in that book, that eternal book, where no one can erase your name. Amen. Amen. Santo Dios. I'm hoping that in 2 weeks, brothers and sisters, I'll be in Nicaragua, in Central America, you know, continuing this ministry, this message. I ask you for your prayers. I'm hoping that in 2 weeks' time, I'll be in Nicaragua, Lord willing. Nicaragua is supposed to be the second poorest nation of the whole Western Hemisphere. So I ask all those who have known me and those new people that have just barely met me today, pray for me, my kids, my family. Pray for the Salt Lake City Mission. Pray for the volunteers. Volunteers that, you know, they come from different religions. No, but it doesn't matter because Jesus says, whatever you have done unto me, whatever you have done unto these little ones, you have done it also unto me. I know they have their names written in the book of life. I know that each of you that is listening right now with your heart, not just with your ears, but with your heart, your name is written in the book of life. And I ask you for your prayers. we go to this mission in Nicaragua, which is supposed to be the second poorest nation of the Western Hemisphere, North, Central, and South America. That's a lot of poverty over there. I mean, we live like...
Look how the Americans treat them. They call them names. Illegal aliens. They ain't illegal aliens.
Amen.
They're the smartest people on the face of this earth.
Amen.
Mexicans know how to think, man.
Amen.
They got good connotation.
Yes, you know. And it's so bad how some people treat the foreign people. You know? The Bible states that we need to treat those who are from other areas, we need to treat them like our own family members. That's what the Good Samaritan did to the injured guy. He wasn't even his race. He wasn't even his kind, but he picked him up and healed, you know, and cured his injuries. We need to be a Good Samaritan. Amen.
I
love each and every one of you guys. You know, every time I come to these events, I see new faces. And it's something that I am so blessed by being able to send this message to you. To all kinds of people, all races, all nations, all different languages.
Thank you very much for all this food, everything. And my microphone, I'm talking to my wife, my sisters, my brothers, everything. Thank you, amen, thank you.
Amen. That was one of our brothers who is thankful for what God has provided, you know, and that's how we need to be, is thankful, you know. It doesn't matter.
And shorty too.
What you need or what you're missing, just be thankful. You know, John the Baptist said, be content with your pay. You know, be content with what you have. Job, when he suffered poverty, you know, because he lost everything, he was thankful. And then God blessed him even more. Amen. I'll close with a prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, I thank you for this moment, for this equipment, for the food, for the clouds, for the trees, for this park, for the city who has permitted us to come here and gather, for those who have shared, for those who are listening to you. I thank you, Lord, because your word has not returned void. I thank you, Jesus, for those people that are here. May you go with them everywhere they go. Some of them will move on to other cities. Some of them will even go out of the country. Be with them. Be with their family, Lord. Protect them. Protect them day and night. Talk to them in dreams and visions. Talk to them, Lord. Just like you have talked to me, Lord, in dreams. Talk to them. And show them. Show them what they must do, what they must decide, Lord. That is my prayer in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Jesus that we see, not the walls or the place, they're not why we celebrate. Come on now and praise the one you seek. All bow down with hearts surrendering. It's not the world that satisfies the thirsty hunger deep inside. Not for wealth, not for fame, that we're gathering His name. Come on now and praise the one you see. All bow down with hearts surrendering. Open heaven's gates, voices raised. Dance to freedom, one loose our chains. It's not you, it's not me, it's only Jesus that we see. Not the walls or the place, they're not why we celebrate. Come on now and praise the one you seek.